Hello friends, welcome to my channel Sparkling Future. Before starting with today's topic, I request all of you to subscribe to my channel, and a new video will be published every day at 11 a.m. Indian Standard Time. So today we are going to discuss about explode transformation in Spark. In explode, again it has three types of functions, like explode outer, post explode outer. So we will discuss in detailed way using some sample code. I have written this code in Scala. So usually explode function is used to split array or map data frame columns into rows. See, this is the sample file that I am taking. If you see, it has name, age, education and year. Here in the education you have three different comma separated values, and here three separated commas, and here only two values with comma separated, and here nothing. So let's see how to deal with this kind of data using the explode transformation. So friends, this is the sample code I have written for implementing this explode functionality. I have created a df and I am reading multidelimeter.csv file. And because of the delimiter, I am using the option as delimiter, and I am using with column, df dot with column qualification. I am giving a new column name, and I am using a explode method. So this is the way we can use the explode method. In the explode, I am passing the parameter as argument as split of this education, because this education needs to be split with comma. So I am mentioning that to the split function, and I am passing that to the explode function. Then once you do this, then I am dropping the column as education, because this explode function, what it exactly does to this input file is, here let's say this maths, physics and chemistry, three values are present under education for the name Ram, right? So now 1 2 3 4 5 rows are there totally as of now. So what will happen is, for ROM, three more rows will be added. I mean, total three rows will be added, with education as maths one row, education as physics in one row, and the third row will be education as chemistry. And these three values, which are name, age and year, will remain the same. Similarly, even for the name Rakesh, three rows will be created with each of these values. So now let's run this code and see how the output will look like. So this is the output, friends. As discussed, for ROM we have under qualification, if you see, then the education is changed to qualification because we are mentioning the column name here, and for maths one row, for physics one row, for chemistry one row. So it's becoming like a traversable functionality. Similarly for Rakesh, we have three comma separated values under education, so it has created. For Madhu, you have three here, so even here you can see three will be created. Similarly for Suman, there are two comma separated values under education, so it has created Suman. And if you notice here, for Radhika, nothing is there in the education field, so it has not considered that name at all. Okay, so now let's see what explode outer does. I am changing that explode outer and I am running the code, friends. So this is the output. Here you can see, for Ram, three rows are created. For Rakesh, three rows. Madhu, three rows. For Suman, two rows. And one row for Radhika is created, but whereas the qualification is null. So the difference between explode and explode outer is explode will not take care when there is a null value in the splitting column, whereas explode outer will consider even the null values. So for if you wanted to consider empty or null values, use explode outer, otherwise use explode. Similarly, we have two more functions called postexplode and postexplode outer. So usually we have to use that postexplode using the select clause. So because of that only I'm writing the query like this. So this actually does the same thing that explode does, but it will do based on the position, and in the output it will give the position and the column name. So let me run this code and show the output to you. So for the execution, now it will create two rows. So each column, like for each position, how many times it has like duplicated. For example, maths, physics, chemistry, right? So for that it will create three rows. Similarly, for the other rows it will create the position and the column. So 0 1 2 0 1 2 something. And if you notice here, for the last one where null is there, it has not considered that one. So now for considered that, we have to pass underscore outer function. We have to use that post explode outer function. If you use this, it will consider the null values as well. So here we have POS and COL, right? So this one can be renamed using data frame dot with column renamed function. Using that function, we can rename the column names to whatever names you wanted to have it. Yeah, it has completed, and now you can see right in the position and the column name. So for each column name with the comma separated one, it has created a three different rows. Similarly here, and wherever that data is empty, column is there, it has substituted that with null. So this is how these four functions works: explode, explode outer, post explode, and post explode outer. So friends, hope this is clear to you. Thank you for watching the video. Please subscribe to my channel for more interesting learnings, and provide your feedback in the comment section. Thank you.